The topic that we are going to discuss is about auto cycle. In the last class, we have discussed the concepts related to Carnot cycle. The continuation of that, we will be discussing the concept of auto cycle, where will be the cycle is associated with four processes. Process 1 to 2, isentropic compression. Process 2, 2 to 3, which is a constant volume heat addition process. Process 3 to 4, isentropic expansion. And process 4 to 1, constant volume heat rejection. These are the basic four processes associated with the auto cycle. Basically, this auto cycle is an air standard cycle for petrol cycle. So as we all know that the efficiency for the auto cycle, the efficiency for any cycle is given by efficiency is equal to network output by heat supply. Here the network output is given by the relation heat supply minus heat rejected by heat supply. Which is given by 1 minus heat rejected by heat supply. In the form of notation, if you want to write it, which is given by 1 minus. The heat is rejected during the process 4 to 1. So which is given by MCV T4 minus T1 by, and the heat is supplied during the process 2 to 3. MCV T3 minus T2. As the mass and the specific heat is constant in the complete cycle, these should be cancelled off. And efficiency is given by 1 minus T4 minus T1 by T3 minus T1. Here we have obtained the relation for efficiency in terms of temperature. But in general, the efficiency of any cycle of the efficiency for auto cycle is given by in terms of compression ratio. So to obtain the relation, we are using the isentropic conditions and the constant pressure relations that what we know from the general gas laws. We are using the relations. So process for process 1 to 2, which is given by isentropic compression. So if you try to write the relation between the temperatures and volumes, which is given by T2 by T1 is equal to D1 by D2 whole power gamma minus 1, which is obtained from the condition PV power gamma is equal to constant and from PV is equal to T. If we realize the things and terms, we will be getting this condition, which is given from this T2 is equal to P1 into D1 minus V2 power gamma minus 1, where D1 by V2 is called as compression ratio, which is given, which is denoted as. So to simplify the condition for efficiency, we are converting each and every temperature term in terms of C1. So we have obtained the relation for T2, which is given by T2 is equal to T1 into RC power gamma minus 1. So for process 2 to 3, we know that which is a constant volume heat addition. So pressure is directly proportional to temperature, which is given, which is obtained from the relation PV is equal to T. As volume is constant, P is directly proportional. equal to T2 into P3 by P2, where P3 by P2 is called as pressure ratio and is denoted with letter R P. Now for process 3 to 4, apply the same isentropic condition that what we have used for process 1 to 2. T4 by T3 is equal to V4 by V3 whole power gamma minus 1. From this, T4 is equal to T3 into V4 by V3 whole power gamma minus 1. As we all know, T3 is equal to T2 into RP, and V4 by V3 is called as expansion ratio and is denoted with the letter RE. As the process is being done, expansion ratio will be equal to compression ratio. So it is denoted with letter R. Therefore, T4 is equal to T2 into RP into R for gamma minus 1. Now substitute all the values of T1, T2, T3, and T4 in the equation 1. So efficiency is equal to 1 minus T4 minus T1 by T3 minus T2. 1 minus T4 is T2 into RP into R power gamma minus 1 minus T1 by T3 value is T2 into RP minus T2. And we obtain value of T2 as T1 into R power gamma minus 1. As T2 is common, we can cancel. 1 minus RP power gamma minus 1 minus T1 by RP. So efficiency is equal to 1 minus. As R power gamma minus is common, we can know. We get efficiency is equal to 1 minus 1 by R power gamma minus 1. This is the efficiency for auto cycle, where R is called as the compression ratio and gamma.